Christmas is a season when people spend for gifts, food, and personal stuff. But ask yourself, are you going overboard? Well, I know I am sometimes. Now, are you spending on a necessity or a want? Colaico Foundation for Education's Executive Director Armand Benko will tell us more about the spending habits of Filipinos during the holidays. Good morning, Armand, and welcome back to Daybreak.
Thank you, and good morning to everyone.
Yeah, so Armand, you know, off-cam we were talking about, you know, somehow better climate for us Filipinos. I mean, we just had this report about 2.5 billion pesos,
billions, dollars,
coming in, remittances from OFWs. But have our spending patterns changed, even with like efforts from your group on teaching Filipinos on how to best spend our money?
Yes, somehow it has changed, but still there's a lot of room for improvement. More so this season, this time of the year. This is the time of the year where we are somehow given the right to splurge, to spend.
Right? Wow, it's for my loved one.
Yes,
it's for me.
13th month or extra bonuses.
Yes.
Compared to the rest of the year, where you may probably be spending on gifts, but only for a special occasion, birthday, anniversary. But this time around is for everyone.
That's right.
Everyone that you meet, colleagues at work, neighbor, family, old friends, reunions, activities. Every step, every action, every corner, you have to spend. So, quite challenging the spending, our spending habits. No matter how we have improved on it, this Christmas season or during the holidays, it's quite a challenge. I will not say a problem, but a real challenge.
Where do we usually bring our money? What do we spend on?
Filipinos are very generous. That's why the pressure of gift giving at this time is at its ultimate high, with the number of people that you have to give gifts to. Well, you thought that you have to give gifts to. That's why we have prepared, if you recall, we did this almost the same time last year.
Yes.
Some gift-giving tips.
All right.
Number one is make that list. It's not only Santa who is making that list and checking it twice. No? We have to make that list and identify who are the people we are to give gifts to, and why?
Kasi the why? Hindi ba pwede because it's just Christmas?
Yes.
kasi sometimes okay, so help us on the why.
Kasi sometimes we end up spending on buying gifts to people that we realize we don't like or we don't want to really give gifts to, and the people that matter to us are compromised. Our family or our loved ones or our those close to us.
Yes.
Answer also the why. Kasi it's always being given, make a list, make a budget, but also put in a qualifier why you are giving that person a gift or why are you spending time, the most important resource. And then also list down the activities that you will be doing. That costs money.
That's what we forget to do.
Reunions or some traditions that you have in your family and places to go to. Those gifts, places to go to, and activities, you write them down and you plan it out. And don't forget the most important question, why you are setting out or...
setting aside money for this
Setting aside money for it. For the actual gifts, we mentioned last year, and I was happy to check the timeline in my Facebook. There was one who shared that, yes, I did this gift suggestion. Remember the deed vouchers. We're familiar with gift checks, vouchers, cash vouchers. Come up with deed vouchers for your family. Mm-hmm. This was shared to us by a big OFW family. Mm-hmm. 18 in the household.
In their household.
So what they did was two family members were exchanging deed vouchers.
So something like, I promise I will help clean your room.
Exactly.
I will clean the kitchen, mommy.
And wash the car for you.
Wash the car for you three times in a specific period.
Because they take turns. They don't have a kasambahay in the household. So when it's your turn to wash the plates, I will take...
But those things should be done even if it's not Christmas, though. So
yes,
maybe something else.
Another is another way to accommodate or meet your gifts.
Yes.
Come up with IOUs.
Uh-huh.
What do I mean by IOUs? The best time to buy gifts is actually December 26 up to December 31. Mm. Those of you who often go to the malls, you would always see come December 26, the day after Christmas, they bring down the prices. Here, even here, in the metropolis. And,
so you're suggesting, like, for example, just a box or a letter that says, I owe you, and your Christmas gift will arrive after
Christmas. Part of the planning, though it's quite late na ngayon, part of the planning is asking what are the wish lists of the important people that you want to give gifts to. And then from those wish lists, probably take a picture from the internet, grab a picture, and send it December 25. This thing is upcoming already because you're just waiting for December 26 to 31st. Mm-hmm. Sometimes they even extend it after New Year. Mm-hmm. The best time to buy or take advantage of sales are right after Christmas.
And I know, and by January, everything, the prices will drop and, you know, everything else is going to be like more affordable.
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
So very, very quickly lang, Armand, you know, the 13th month pay, a lot of people already got it and some will be getting their 13th month pay and their bonuses. Okay, what would you suggest to them? What should they do with it?
I actually prepared the list, but with lacking of time, just one very important reminder, control the momentum or stop the momentum. What do I mean? During this time, because of the extra resources, financial resources, it's like we're possessed inside the money that we will be buying, and you go home.
With all the you're possessed. Okay, so what should we do, Armand?
Pause for every expenditure. Pause for every time that you spend.
Yes.
Pause, review, check your list. Because the power of the pause, more so in spending, contributes a lot. Mm-mm. Yung iba kasi parang talagang...
Yeah. Parang I have money. It's extra
and,
money anyway.
Forget yourself in the meantime. Forget yourself. Because as you mentioned at the start of the segment, we buy gifts for activities that we spend on and things
and
that
ourselves.
We for ourselves during Christmas. Sometimes we have to forget ourselves in the meantime. The rewarding comes later. Delayed gratification is more effective than immediate gratification.
So make that list.
Make that list.
Pause before spending anything.
Yes.
Be kind to those who will follow this, and then you can give your gifts after Christmas. Just make a note and say that this is what I'll be giving you, right? Well, very smart ideas. I might really be doing that, Armand. Well, thank you so much for joining us this morning. Again, we've just spoken with Armand Benko, Executive Director of Kalaika Foundation for Education Incorporated.